We have somebody on the phone. We have not only Steve, but also Lucy. Now, they have a home in Key West that they boarded up and left, but they're still riding out the storm at a hotel nearby.
They are on the phone with us now. Steve, Lucy, you there?
Yep, we're here.
Hey, how are you?
Doing well. More important question is, how are you?
Oh, it's
getting real at this point.
So we're getting a little real. We're actually out on our balcony on Duval. We're in a hurricane-resistant hotel. Better off than if we stayed in our apartment. We can overlook Duval right now, and it's just a ghost town. I mean, all of the businesses have boarded up. Things are getting real. The lights are still on. The gusts are not bad.
It started about midnight. It's been like a consistent little breeze. Maybe to like the wind stage, and it's just super eerie at this point.
I can imagine. So you're at the Saint Hotel, which is on Duval Street, and you actually have a balcony, so you're able to see what's going on. We're looking at the bands of Irma right now, and it looks like you're just in between two. So it doesn't look
right.
Like you're getting the mass amounts of rains that are coming your way. That's really in the upper Keys at the moment. So
right.
What made you board up your home, but then still stay in town and go to a nearby hotel?
Initially, for myself, I was going to stay at my home and have some people over just to bunker down. But as soon as that was when it wasn't going to directly hit us, and that was when it was like going to be a Category 3, and it was still going up the East Coast. But as soon as it took that direct, the path right towards us, we realized that the structures we were in, at this point, options were pretty limited for us down here. So I think... Thankfully, Lucy's boyfriend had the opportunity to get a room where we're staying. It's his job, so now we're here.
And at this point, we just figure it would be safe to just hunker down here than be on the road in cars going north, not knowing where we get gas next.
Right. Or the direction of the storm, for that matter.
You know, the authorities, certainly Monroe County, I've been urging people to get out for several days now, saying don't discount or undercut the significance of the impact of what it could do there. I wonder why or what went into the thought process of, I'm sure you heard those warnings, why you thought you might be better off or why you decided not to take it early and go.
Well, again, for myself, I never second guessed myself. I knew I was saying this is my home, and unless you're in a situation where you're put in that predicament, whether to leave or not leave, you know, you have to make that decision. I mean, I want to be here to help and do whatever I can for everybody to be here and may not be able to get back here for weeks, maybe in a month, maybe 2 months. I mean, we have no idea, but somebody has to be here. And we have a great community. I mean, it's one human family down there. There's a select group of us that are here, and we're all willing to do the same thing. And I think we all pretty much feel the same way about where we are.
We certainly understand that. I think that's everybody's conundrum. You don't want to leave your home and your possessions and maybe your pets, you know, anything that you're used to. And especially for you guys, you would have to drive so far. But that is the concern. You just said it perfectly. We're worried about not being able to get to you. So in other words, bridges being down or destroyed,
right,
and not being able to get those trucks with fuel and water and food. It might, we're talking worst case scenario here. It may take some time of rebuilding and fixing.
Right.
And we may have to use boats in the duration. I mean, we're really thinking of all the
right
possibilities. So I have to think, us here in the mainland, we prepare for 3 to 7 days. You gotta have water and food for 3 to 7 days. You guys down there, you gotta prepare. You just said it perfectly. You said weeks, maybe month more?
Right, right.
We have so much water, canned goods, provisions. We're in a hotel that has also made sure that they've had enough provisions in case we stay. So we not only have our personal provisions here, we also have the help of a business who was able to call Cisco or, you know, any food operating manufacturer to get supplies down here in preparation. So at this point, there's only so much that I can load into my Kia Forte and go north, but I have a bunker and a lot more water than I could ever hope for.
Right, and from what I've understood, there's some weak bridges between some mile marker. I can't be certain, but if, God forbid, something happens to those bridges, it's going to take time for people to be able to drive back here. And that's pretty much everybody who left. I mean, that's everybody who left. So being able to be prepared or over-prepared, you know, I'd rather be over-prepared than under-prepared, obviously, but...
Here we are.
I wonder if you've seen anybody else down there.
No. I mean, at our where we're staying, no. And throughout the evening, we've seen a few bikes lift and people, like, walking. But, like, my roommate is staying at the La Concha Hotel, and that hotel is completely booked. When I spoke to her earlier, there's just tons of people. But at this point, I think it's probably best that we all stay where we are, even though it's nothing at this point, just besides a little wind and light rain at some point. But we know it's going to get serious, and staying put is probably the smartest thing we could do at this point.
Oh, yeah. Stephen,
wait till after the storm.
Stephen and Lauren, you're not going anywhere. We would definitely tell you, you are not leaving. You've made your decision. You have to stick with it.
Yep.
La Concha,
oh, yeah.
Go ahead.
I just said 100%. Yeah, our minds have never changed.
Okay, good. La Concha, I'm very familiar with. I have been at Channel 10 for almost 14 years, and 04 and 05, I think that was my home away from home, because every storm that was headed in our direction, we were down there.
That
is one of those places that you're at the highest level in Key West, is in terms of, you know, a lot of Key West is at sea level.
And we are two blocks away from that, and that's why we decided to stay here.
Right.
I mean, we've done the best that we can.
Right.
So.
And, I mean, tomorrow morning they're opening up shelters for, like, the last resorts. But we were graciously given this, and thank goodness, because the stress already, even being prepared, was a lot and still is a lot. So having the thought that we still didn't have somewhere to go would just be too much.
Okay, well, we just want to send you our thoughts and prayers, and we hope you stay safe, because right now, you know, we know this can change, but right now, the eye of that storm, you know, the worst hurricane winds set to head your way, so we just really hope that you guys are okay and that you stay safe, and we hope to talk to you after this is over.
For sure.
Hey,
keep our number.
We'll see you on the other side.
And by that, we mean the other side of the bridge. So
there you go. True Key West conks down there. I love it. All right. Thank you so much for talking to us.
Wow.
I know. I worry. And I have to mention to all our viewers right now, they're in Key West. They're not going anywhere. And I do agree with that. They're already getting these bands coming in their direction. But if any of you are changing your mind, we have to tell you, those refuge of last resort choices that Stephen just mentioned, Coral Shores High School, Marathon High School, Sugarloaf School, and Key West High School. Because I think sometimes when you make a decision, at the last minute you say, oh my gosh, did I make the right choice?
Call.
So that's for this reason. There are a couple places you can go, four places, if you just say, forget it, where I'm at, I don't think I can make it through.
We're certainly hoping to talk to those two safely on the other side in the next few days.